السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. الحمد لله الحمد لله وحده، والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده. اللهم صل وسلم على عبدك ورسولك محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وسلم تسليما كثيرا، أما بعد. قال الله تبارك وتعالى: وقل جاء الحق وزهق الباطل إن الباطل كان زهوقا. Brothers and sisters and my respected beloved viewers of JMC Facebook Live viewers and our JMC Musallis and our neighbors, brothers and sisters, those who are watching this program from here, from any part of the country or any part of the world. This is indeed great blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah azza wa jal has given us tawfiq to come to his house and speak about the people which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given them glad tidings of, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given them name of radiyallahu anhu wa radu an for blessing the title of please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are talking about the life of Sahaba radiyallahu ta'ala alayhi ajma'in. Yeah, last week we talked about Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiyallahu ta'ala. Inshallah, today we like to talk about Sayyidina Umar, who was the second Khalifa of Islam. The man who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed some of the ayat of Quran according to his comments and according to his intention. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decided to reveal the ayat of the Quran, and that is Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala. It is impossible to go to every single details of his life and every step of his life. So we'll try to summarize some part of his life. We can take a lesson from those type of stories of his life, inshallah ta'ala. So let's first start talking about his acceptness of Islam. Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala, he was a very courageable man, very strong person. Always he was not fear of anything. This type of person he was. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one time he made dua. Talha radiallahu ta'ala, he said, I heard, Khabbab radiallahu ta'ala, he said, I heard from Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he made dua for two persons. Amr ibn Hisham, who we call Abu Jahl, and Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he asked to Allah azza wa jal to give any one of them, whoever Allah likes, to give them tawfiq to accept Islam. It will help Muslims and Islams. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted dua on for Umar radiallahu ta'ala, and Allah blessing the Islam. So that day they have decided to, and they have announced that who can murder Prophet Muhammad, they will give him price as a 100 camel. So he is the one who said, Umar, that I will do that. And then he started running to with his fulfill his intention. On the way, he found one of the Sahaba and asked him, where are you going? Then he said, you know the other story that I want to make very short, that he said, where are you going? And he said his intention, that to kill Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa alayhi wa sallam. And then he, in one point, he said, you want to kill Prophet of Allah, but remember one thing, before you do this, go to your house and see what's going on in your house with your sisters and your brother-in-law. So he went there. He knocked the door. He went inside the door. He slapped his sister. Then he also grabbed his brother-in-law, asked them what he was doing. And they, one point, they say, they hide themselves. At one point, when he went inside, because everybody used to afraid of Amar. So one, in one point, when he went to his house and asked Allah his sisters and his brother-in-law about Sayyidina Amar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. When Sayyidina Amar he started screaming on them what he was doing. Then he bring the part of Quran where they used to recite Surah Al-Taha. Then he recited Taha ma anzalna alayka al-Quran al-Tashqa. Until the ayat, innani alallah la ilaha illa ana fa'budni wa aqimis salata li dhikri. When he heard this ayat, which is Allah, where Allah mentioned, Allah is the one who people can worship and pray their salat and pay their zakat. Then his heart is start shaking. And then, after he heard that ayat, then he start crying. When he start crying, Khabbab radiallahu ta'ala who was teaching them Quran and he was hiding in their house. Then he came out and then he told him about the dua of the prophets, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then he immediately he said, "Dalluni ala Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam." Khabbab radiallahu ta'ala start taking to him to the haram where Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to sit with some Sahaba, where the Ibn Arqam house, next to Darul Arqam, they were sitting on that house. Hamza radiallahu ta'ala anhu was standing there. And then, when he went to the door, Hamza radiallahu ta'ala anhu grabbed his collar, and then he hold his sword, and then he asked him about the Prophet. And then immediately Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came out, and then asked him, "O Umar, what are you waiting for? Are you still waiting for the punishment of Allah, which is the punishment come for the Mughira? You still waiting for that type of punishment?" Umar immediately replied, "Ashadu annaka wa ashadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashadu annaka Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh." He accepted Islam. And then, when he accepted Islam, he was about 40 people, men and women, then accepted Islam. After that, he accepted Islam. When Rasulullah was so happy, and then after that, Muslims started openly, they went to the prayer, to the Haram, in Kaaba, front of the Kaaba. Before that, nobody pray directly live to the Kaaba because afraid of the other kuffar. And then because of his things, Sayyidina Umar and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam give him the title of Farooq after a long time. But the meaning of title of Farooq is that who understand the difference between Haq and Batil. So what is truth and what is false? He is the one who can differ in between Haq and Batil, because he was very strong about this. So Rasulullah has given him the title of the word Farooq. And in respect of him, subhanAllah alhamdi. So Rasulullah said one day he was sleeping. He saw a dream. Jibril alayhi salam, he took him somewhere. Then in one part he went to Jannah. This is the dream. This was the dream of the Prophet himself. So one Prophet in the dream, he saw in the Jannah that the palace, very nice place, built with moti, jamarud, and all these things, those expensive stones. And then he saw a woman was doing wudu next to the palace. Prophet ﷺ asked to Jibreel, "Whose palace is that?" And who is that woman? Jibreel immediately replied, this is the house of your ghulam, Amr, and she will be the wife of your ghulam, Amr. Prophet, when he wake up at the Fajr time, Rasulullah was used to, he explained his dream to Sayyidina Amr, radiallahu anhu, and then say, Ya Amr, I saw a dream like that, but I had a little bit of shy to go to your, I was intent to go to your palace. So I feel that because you are a strong person, I feel that you will not mind because of go to your house before you see your wife and your palace. And Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala say, Ya Rasulullah, how do you think about me, about these things? So Umar radiallahu ta'ala started crying. And that is the in shan of Rasul Sayyidina Umar, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has made this the things he said he saw in the Jannah about Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala. When he used to talk, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him this much power of his talk and this much hikmat in his talk. Other Sahaba used to say, when Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala he talk, looks like malaika is talking, angel is talking. One thing before that, my brothers and sisters, I just want to share with you something and I hope you understand that. This is not a waz mahfil. This is our daily class, you can say. Our daily academic class program to learn something. Not this is the waz mahfil or here, then you don't forget everything after we done. There's something to learn about, to take a lesson from this type of program. That's why we are doing this program like a class. So I hope you understand, inshallah, and try to learn something and take a lesson from our talk and our rest of our scholars, those who are giving talk every night at 9 o'clock, inshallah ta'ala. One time, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, one time he went for a Hajj. So what happened? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Jibreel to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When people was asking dua to Allah in the time of Arafah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called angels and said to look at to everyone, those who are in the Hajj, look at to the people, how they are making tawbah and how they are asking forgiveness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala especially separately mentioned the name of Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu and said to the angels, look at the Umar. All the Hujjaj, those who are in Hajj, Allah made them together and told the angels to look at them. And Allah separated Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu from the Hujjaj and said, look at Umar, how he is tawbah and how he is asking forgiveness. Look at his ibadat. I mean, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives special value of ibadat of Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given special ilm to Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. So another time, Rasulullah was sleeping and he saw a dream. He said, there is a bone, like a pot, and this whole entire pot was filled up with the water. And he was very thirsty. So he said, I drink some of the water from that bowl, and rest of the water, I fill up my whole stomach. It looks like the water is coming from my finger, this much water I have drink. And after that, the same bowl with the rest of the water, I give it to Umar. And then Umar starts drinking. Sahaba asked me, Ya Rasulullah, what is the ta'bir? What is the explanation of this dream? Rasulullah said, this is the ilm. Which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will transfer ilm from me after my death to Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala. He was this much knowledgeable person. Subhanallah bihamdi. Now we go back to his hijrah. This is the time when he was in Makkah remember one thing. As I had mentioned last week, Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu's sixth generation is reached to Quraysh and also to Murrah, to one of the grandfather of great grandfather of Prophet Islam, live in sixth generation to meet to Rasulullah lineage of Prophet Islam. And Umar radiallahu ta'ala, his lineage is meet in eighth generation of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The next thing I want to talk about the Hijrah. When time of Hijrah of Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala, after Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had migrated from Makkah to Medina, and everyone, we know that every Sahaba, even Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam including himself, that was the hukum of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why Rasulullah, he migrated from Makkah to Medina. But when the time of after the migration of the Rasulullah Hijrah, other Sahaba, they migrated also from Makkah to Medina hiddenly. Nobody saw how they migrated. Some of them, they migrated from Makkah to Medina at night. But when time of Umar radiallahu ta'ala came, he wanted to migrate. So what he did, he fixed his sword, and then he picked up his arrows, and then he fixed his arrows properly, and then he openly went to the Kaaba, and he do sab'a tawaf. He do seven times tawaf, and then he come to Maqam Ibrahim, pray two rakah, and that time all the leader of the Quraysh was sitting there, and they watched him. After he prayed two rakat in Maqam Ibrahim, he drank zamzam. And then he went to those leader of the Quraysh. And he invited them again for Islam. When nobody accepted, then he said, okay, you don't accept it, no problem. But I accept it. And I am, everybody hiddenly migrated from Makkah to Medina. But I am openly going to Makkah to Medina. If any one of you want to make your children yatim, any one of you want to make your wife widow, any one of you want to make your mother, your children die, then you come to face me, face to me, I am leaving Makkah to Medina to meet Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah openly, but no one come to face Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala. He had this much courage, he had this much strong belief and faith for Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him this strong faith on his heart. And this hikmat Allah has given, bless him with this. Now see how powerful, how much powerful this man he is. I want to pay attention to here. I hope everybody please pay attention in this the next part of his life. So look at his power. This much powerful man, nobody can face him. Nobody can face him. When he migrated from Makkah to Medina after the demise of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he passed away, when Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala passed away, this much strong man, when he becomes second Khalifa, Allahu Akbar. Look at his tawadu, and look at his humbleness, and look at his kindness. Look at his kindness. So his house, when he was Khalifa, his house was next to Masjid al-Nabawi, and Abbas radiallahu ta'ala's house was also next to house of Masjid al-Nabawi. So Abbas radiallahu ta'ala was uncle of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So one day he was going to Masjid al-Nabawi, it was Friday, for leading Jum'ah Salat. And that time he was Khalifa, Khalifatul Muslimin, Amirul Mu'mineen, the leader, the president, the prime minister, whatever you can name it. So he was passing by, and the drop of water, drop of little bit of dirty water, is fall on his cloth from the roof of Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu's house. There was a small, like a pipe, two roof come together, and there the like a gutter, you can say gutter. So gutter water, little bit of gutter water, it drop off on his clothes. And then his clothes become dirty. So he becomes so angry. So he went to house back again and he changed his clothes. Then he come for reading of Jummah. So when he was going, second time after he changed his clothes, then he told someone, he called someone and told him, show him that gutter pipe, open this, because of this pipe, my clothes become dirty. If anyone walking that way, anytime can water drop and then his clothes become dirty. After all these things happened, Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, after Salat, he came home and he saw that gutter was open. He's on the floor. So he asked, who did this? Then he find out that Sayyidina Abu radiallahu ta'ala anhu did. So he become a little bit upset. See, he went to Amr radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And he said to Amr, oh Amr, did you open that gutter? Amr radiallahu ta'ala said, yes. Then before he asked him anything, that why you did that, he only asked him, do you know that who put this gutter pipe in there, whatever it is, like a gutter? He said, no. He said, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he himself with his Mubarak hand, he put it this, and how did you open this? Look at the tawadu and humbleness of Sayyidina Umar. He become this much humble and he say, Ya Abbas, I am right now coming there and I will sit there and you pick up, you take this pipe and you step on my shoulder. You step on my shoulder and put this pipe back again. You don't do that, I will not move from there until you step on my shoulder. And then he put it back. Who said this? Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Who is the person who Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked to Allah to bless for Islam? The person who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed ayat of the Quran because of his comments. The person who migrated from Makkah to Medina openly, nobody can have courage to face him. He is the Sayyidina Umar. Radiallahu ta'ala anhu. The time of when the Battle of Badr took place, when Kufar of Quraysh got war prisoner, then Sahaba sat for the Mashwara, Rasulullah sat for the Mashwara, asked everybody's opinions. So everybody say, some of them say, okay, forgive them and release them. Some of them say, that okay, take some ransom and release them. Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said the same thing. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked to Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and he said, all of these leaders of Quraysh, or all the people of Quraysh, those who are here, who are prisoners, they are somewhere, they are our relatives. So I will give my opinion that, call our relatives, their relatives, those who are prisoners, and let them take the sword from sword, and you cut the neck of your own relative. And immediately Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the ayat and say the opinion of Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Allah like his opinion. That is a man who say, this much powerful man, Allah love him. This much powerful man becomes so much humble that, and he was Amir al-Mu'mineen, he was the Khalifa, he was the president. And he said, okay, I will sit there and he step on my shoulder and then push your pipe back. Look at the humbleness. We should take lesson from this thing, my brothers and sisters. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah has created every single thing for the Prophet. He is the one who opened the door of Jannah first. He is the one who raised in the day of judgment first. He is the one who asked to Allah, intercede to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to start the code of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's the one who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has accepted the dua of him to studying the curriculum of the Day of Qiyamah. Subhanallah alhamdulillah. And who, he is the person who, if we deny any word of him, then we cannot be in the fold of Islam anymore. Allahu Akbar. He is Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said about these things, tawadu, he said that, Ana sayyidi waladi adam wala fakhar. Allahu Akbar. I am the one who the son of Sayyidina Adam alayhi salatu wa salam. But I do not have no pride. I do not have no pride. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Man kana fi qalbi misqala dharratin min kabar, wala yadkhulu al-jannah. Even those who have mustard seed of pride in their hearts, they will not enter Jannah. May Allah ta'ala give us tawfiq to act upon those things. Brothers and sisters, that was the life of Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And the person who was this much humbleness is another lesson we should take. Always, if anybody start correcting us, we are human beings, most of the time we make mistakes. If we make any mistake and people try to correct us, we become angry. Very fast we become angry. But he's the man, Sayyidina Umar, radiallahu ta'ala, also a powerful man. He used to say that if anyone correct me anything, and anyone who can looking for my faults and tell me this is your wrong, you did wrong, I will become so much happy. I will respect and I love that person who always try to looking for my faults and tell me this is your fault, you correct it. So that's why, if anytime anybody, you know that the five fingers are not same. You cannot find everybody's thinking as same. Some people they can say humbly, some people they can say with anger, some people they cannot say the things the way you like. So whatever people say, remember the things, what is my wrong, what is my fault. We try to correct our faults instead of saying that, oh, who are you to correct me? I am Imam of Masjid, I am Hafiz, I am Alim, I am Mufti, I am this, I am that, so-called I am this and that. Who are you? You just come to Masjid there and you pray behind me. And I saw you the month ago, you was smoking a cigarette outside over there. And now you come inside the Masjid and correcting me. This is totally wrong, brothers. Anybody can correct us. Anybody can correct you. Whoever is correcting us, we should always listen and respect and thank to that person, those who correct in us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to rectify ourselves. Now, one time, also, as I have mentioned, Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, in the time of the Battle of Badr, also Allah revealed the ayat, and the ayat of Hijab. There is a tradition of Arab. People used to come sit together, men and women used to eat together. When they have invited guests, guests used to come. Sometimes Prophet used to invite guests, some Sahaba used to come sit together, eat together with men and women together. So sometimes the wife of Rasulullah sitting together and eating together with other Sahaba. That time the hukum of parda, hukum of hijab did not come, did not reveal yet. So what happened? When Rasulullah, Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala, he saw this. One day he was sitting with them and eating, and he saw one of the Sahaba's hand touch the hand of one of the Ummahatul Mu'mineen, and he became so upset in his mind. Then what happened? He intentionally said that, oh Allah, if you revealed and give hukum of parda, hukum of hijab, I think it will be better for our Muslim women, our wives and our daughters and our sisters. Immediately, subhanAllah, alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, within in next morning, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam give this khush khabri, this bashar, this tidings to Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala, that Allah SWT has revealed the ayat of hijab. So that was the connection of Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu with Allah Azza wa Jalla. He was this much powerful man and this much muttaqi man, which Rasulullah so many times said, if anyone will become prophet after me, then lakana Umar, then it will be Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Now look at his insaf. And look at the love of religion, and look at the love of Islam, and love of the Jannah. He used to wear very ordinary clothes. He used to take very ordinary food, even he was a Khalifa. One time, his wife asked him that, if I am not wrong, I believe was Eid al-Fitr. So his young children, asked to his mother to buy some clothes for him, for them. So his wife come to him and then asked to buy something in the time of occasion of Eid al-Fitr. So Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, I don't have no money to buy. The person who was the Khalifa of the Muslim, he said, I have no money to buy. So his wife suggested him to go to your chadra and take the advance salary for next month from your Baitul Mal. So Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he went to his treasurer and then asked to treasurer to, can you please pay me advance for next month of my salary? So I need it. And after that, his treasurer, so he's one of the Sahaba, his treasurer bring a piece of paper and then give it to Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala and say, Ya Umar, I will give you your advance salary for next month, but you do me a favor, you know what you do, can you please write down on that piece of paper that you will be alive on next month? Allahu Akbar. You will be guaranteed that you will be alive on next month. If you write it down this one, I will give you the money. Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala, he started crying. And then he did shukr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and say, Wa Allah, I have in my khilafat people like this person, people like treasurer like him, this amanatdar, trusty person. Wa Allah, I do shukr of you, Wa Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he don't take this. And then he said, how the Khalifa, and then how is the Khalifa? Same thing is the treasurer. And the last thing of his life, when Allahu Akbar, you know that Abu Lulu, he killed Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu in the time of Fajr Salat when he arrived. Then he put his step on his stomach. And then after that, look how he was worry about Salat, and then was bleeding, and people was trying to close the hole with something, but it still was bleeding. Because of bleeding, so people were talking to him. His son Abdullah come and then put his head on his lap, and then he said, no, put my head on the ground so people can see how powerful Umar was. And the time of death, his head is on the ground. And his first comment to his son, Abdullah ibn Umar, and Abdurrahman ibn Auf was there. And then he said, when Abdurrahman ibn Auf asked, Ya Umar, how do you feel? His reply, that, oh Abdurrahman, how was the salat I have left? His first comment, how was the Salat? And then he ordered Sayyidina Abdurrahman ibn Auf, oh Abdurrahman ibn Auf, go and continue Salat where I left over. Then Abdurrahman ibn Auf, then he went there, then he started continuing Salat from there. And then, after the step of Abu Lulu, he lied about 3 days. So after 3 days, Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu passed away. In these 3 days, one time, people come together, including Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and they ask him, because during his Khilafat time, during his lifetime, he met a shura of 6 people. Everybody knows it's a long story. I want to make it short. So he don't put his son in that shura. Because people cannot say, Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he did favor on his son. So he don't put his son in there. So after that, a day before his death, people give him mashwara that, you know, what do you do? Can you please declare the name of next Khalifa? So some of them, they suggested, why you don't declare about your son, Umar Abdullah? He is a great alim, he is knowledgeable like you, and we know him. I think he is eligible for it, and he is fit for the Khalifa. Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala, I know he's an alim, but you know what? I can't do that. The reason is that one time he made one mistake, that he divorced his wife during the time of Hayat, when his wife was in monthly menstrual, on a monthly cycle. He talaqaha, he divorced her on that time, which is according to Sharia law of Islam, this time a husband cannot divorce the woman. And that time Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was alive. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam told Umar to withdraw your talaq, and he did that. Then he said, the person who don't know the right way of talaq, the person who don't know how to divorce the woman, how I can give the khilafah to that person for the khilafah of Muslimin? Look at the insaf of Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. That much he is an insufferable man. Now, this much fear of Allah he had, this much he understand about the haqq al-batil, which is Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam give him great title of the Faruq. He know the difference between haqq and batil. When Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu asked that before his death, oh Umar, why you crying? He was crying. You afraid of death? Afraid of death? Umar radiallahu ta'ala replied, oh Ali, I am not afraid of death. I am not crying because of death. I am crying, what will happen to me after death? What will happen to me after death? Allahu Akbar. Now Umar radiallahu ta'ala, who will raise with Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the day of judgment, and which is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam giving great tidings for the Jannah. He said, what will happen to after death? One time he said that if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have select all entire human being for the Jannah, and he announced the name of only one person, he is Jahannami, then I have afraid, I have fear that I will be that person of Jahannam. And then also he said, look at the strong iman and amal on Allah and love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One time he said, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala declared that all of the human beings are Jahannami and only one person is Jannati, I hope that Allah will declare my name is for the Jannati. Subhanallah alhamdulillah. And during his lifetime, one time he asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ya Rasulullah, what is the question in the grave? And we know all of us memorize this question, Mar Rabbuka, Wama Dinuka, Wama Nabiyuka. This is saying these things is easy, my brothers and sisters. But remember these things. If we are not act upon this, we cannot say all this answer of the question. Remember, if we have no act upon it. Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala or Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, Allah will ask these 3 questions, Mar Rabbuka, Wama Dinuka, Wama Nabiyuka. And Umar radiallahu ta'ala will say, ya Rasulullah, he sure this is the question Allah will ask? Rasulullah will say, yes, I'm sure. Then Umar radiallahu ta'ala will say, O Prophet of Allah, you be witness that then I prepare myself for this answer of this question. Allahu Akbar. Look at this, is the Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. So, one time he used to say, this is the one of the call of Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala, all the time he used to say, تَحَسَبُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ قَوْلَ أَن تُحَاسَبُ. Allahu Akbar. Make hisab of your life before you give hisab to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You make your own accountability before you accountable when face accountability to Allah azza wa ta'ala. What is this, my brother and sister? We look our faults, we look our ibadah, how we do, are we doing ibadah sincerely or not? Or we are doing ibadah and khidmat for deen, for the showing of people, or doing for Allah azza wa jal. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to take lesson from Sayyidina Umar, life of Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu. There is the lifetime, there is the kitab, which is muhaddithin, mufassirun, and writers and great authors and ulama have written on his life, the books on his life. So I will request everybody, all of our viewers, to take this, any language you can see, the life of Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu, read the life of Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu, read the book of life of Umar radiallahu anhu. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to understand this and act upon these things, inshaAllah ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا أستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين أستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of us from this pandemic. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remove this punishment, this azab from all entire world. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised them in Jannah, those who are passed away in this pandemic. And people, those who are doing service, khidmat for the people, those who are affected by this virus, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also guide them to the right path. And those who have iman, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help all of us. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina wa ala Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك اشهد ان لا اله الا انت استغفرك واتوب اليك وجزاكم الله خير. السلام عليكم ورحمه الله وبركاته.